So in this section, we will see about a other type of a microwave component, which is called as a rat race junction, or it can also be called as a hybrid ring. Okay. So what we are doing is that to a normal three-port T, we are adding another port. That is, a fourth port is added to a normal three-port T. Okay. So how it is constructed? Now, this is a structure or the construction of a rat race junction or a hybrid ring. It is constructed by folding of rectangular waveguides into circular waveguides. So here, to a normal three-port T, we are adding a fourth port. So we are having a four-port junction in a rat race, okay, where the total circumference is 1.5 lambda g by 4. So the necessary condition of the construction for a hybrid ring is that the total circumference of this particular ring, since it is a circular ring, we call it as a ring structure. So the total circumference must be 1.5 lambda g by 4. The four ports are connected in the form of an annular ring at proper intervals by means of junction. So the constructional details are, say, port 1 and port 2, they are separated by a distance of lambda g by 4, port 2 and 3 by lambda g by 4, port 3 and 4 again by lambda g by 4, and port 1 and port 4 by 3 lambda g by 4. So it is for the proper working or for the sustaining of the standing waves, we are placing the distance of the ports as such. Okay, so the distance between the ports are to be kept as such. So what will be the total circumference if you add all this? It will be here 3 lambda g by 4, and again between port 1 and 4 again 3 lambda g by 4. So totally the value is 6 lambda g by 4, which is nothing but 1.5 lambda g by 4. So this is how a hybrid ring or a rat race junction is being constructed. So as seen from the construction of a hybrid ring or a rat race circuit, we are going to separate the port by electrical distances in terms of its guide wavelength to properly sustain the operation and produce standing waves. So you can see, when we are supplying, say, input, say, from port 1, it goes to port 4 in the clockwise direction and it goes to port 2 in the anti-clockwise direction. So, but the wave is going to come out, say, from port 4 and port 2, but nothing is going to come out from port 3. Okay, so this is the function of this hybrid ring. Similarly, for any reasons, if you are applying, say, the input applied at port 3, it is again going to split in anti-clockwise and clockwise direction ports 2 and 4, but at the output at the port 1 will be 0. So this is how a hybrid ring is going to work. So we can use such a type of ring either to combine the signal or divide a signal into two equal halves. And the other thing to remember is that there may be small leakage couplings. Therefore, the zero elements in the S matrix, they are not quite equal to zero. Even though we assume some elements for our easiness to be zero for solving the S matrix in an easier manner, they are not actually practically equal to zero, since there will be always coupling leakage associated with the ring. So now, to derive the S matrix, what we do, we try to minimize the number of elements in the S matrix and then apply the unitary property to find out the elemental values of S matrix. So considering our rat race junction, we are having here four ports. So first of all, we can assume that all these four ports, they are being matched to these junctions so that there is no mismatch or no reflection. So the diagonal elements in the S matrix, being a four port junction, it can be considered to be zero. Okay, so that is why in the S matrix we have written S11, S22, S33, S44 to be equal to 0. That is, all ports are matched. So the diagonal elements in the S matrix turns to be 0. Now considering about the input output conditions. Suppose, say, we are applying the input, say, at port number 1. So it is going to port 4 and port 2, one in the clockwise and anti-clockwise direction, because of the phase difference, if one is positive, other will be negative. So we can write here, say S21 is equal to minus of S41, or S12 is equal to minus of S14, either way, since there is symmetry property in the S matrix. And also we know that if we apply an input at port 1, it will be appearing at port 2 and port 4, but it will not be coming at port 3. So S13 and S31 will be 0. Similarly, if you apply say input at port 2, it will be appearing at port 1 and port 3, but nothing appears at port 4. So S24 and S42 will be 0. So incorporating these three input output condition, now we have reduced our S matrix. So seeing the S matrix, we have to find out the value of S12, S23 and S34. Then we can get the value of S matrix for a rat race junction. So what will be our next step? We have to apply the unitary property of S matrix, that is S into S conjugate is equal to identity matrix, and get the elemental values for the S. So by considering the unitary property of S matrix, now we have to solve for the three values of the S elements. By reducing the S matrix, now we have to find the value of S12, S23 and S34. So to find out these three values, we consider the unitary property and take S into S conjugate is equal to the identity matrix. So solving it further, taking R1, C1, okay, matrix multiplication, we get the value of S12 as 1 by root 2. Taking R2 into C2, we get the value of S23 as 1 by root 2. And taking R3 into C3, we get the value of S34 as 1 by root 2. So now we are able to write the S matrix finally for our hybrid ring or our rat race ring. Okay. So when you are asked to derive the S matrix of hybrid ring, make sure to give the figure, explain the property or just state the property, and write the reduced form of S matrix, and then solve it by using the unitary property, and finally show the elemental values for the S matrix for a hybrid ring. Now we always consider the rigid waveguides, okay, but in certain application it becomes necessary to change the direction of a guide by an arbitrary angle. So in some cases we will be having flexible waveguides, say in the form of bends, twist, corners, etc. So this figure shows an example of some of the flexible waveguide, H bend, E bend or a twist, etc. So all these are basically used for arbitrary adjusting or changing a direction of a waveguide. So these bends or twists, they are used in application where certain criterias, they may not be fulfilled by the normal waveguides. So here we see some other type of flexible waveguides. It can be corners, it can be bends, it can be twist, etc. Now we have to understand that for a H bend, okay, so if the bend is in the wider dimension of the waveguide, the H lines are affected. That is why this is a H bend. Now if the bending, okay, if it is going to take place in the narrower dimension, so the E lines are affected, so we are having a E bend. We call this as a E bend. Okay, so wider dimension change, H lines affected and H bend, and narrow dimension only if we are going to make the bend, then E lines are affected, it is called as a E bend. And twist, we usually employ a 45 degree twist or a 90 degree twist, etc. So 45 degree twist we have seen in isolators. Okay, it is usually used for changing the plane of polarization, say from horizontal to vertical or vice versa. Now in low frequencies, the bends need to be very long. Okay, so we can use the corners instead of bends. Okay, so depending upon our suitable application, if we need to change a pattern all of a sudden, so in case we have to make our bend more and more long, so in such cases we can use corners. So we can use the E-plane corner or a H-plane corner. And the thing here to be noted is that here capital L is representing the mean length between the continuities. Okay, so here capital L is the length, mean length between the continuities of the waveguide, and after that only the guide is getting a bent, or it is going to a corner, or it is going to a twist. So L always represents the length, mean length between the continuities. So this is the examples of all the flexible waveguide: a bent or a continuous twist. Twist is always used for changing the direction of polarization of the wave. Here also capital L represents the mean distance between the continuities, and capital R here represents the radius of curvature of the bent, and A and B here are the dimensions of the waveguide. So all these waveguide components, that is whatever example figures which I have shown here, they are normally used to change the direction of the guide through an arbitrary angle. And another condition is mentioned here, that is we know that capital L is what? It is the mean length between the continuities of the waveguide. It should be equal to an odd number of quarter wavelength. Okay, so this is a quarter wavelength, 1 by 4 of lambda g, where lambda g is the wavelength in the waveguide. It should be a multiple of the odd number. So here odd number is 2n plus 1, where n can be integers ranging from 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. So why this condition is maintained? It is because if the mean length L is an odd number of quarter wavelength, the reflected waves from both ends of the waveguide section are completely cancelled. So our intention is only for providing, say, a bent. Okay, so we have to change the direction of the wave which is propagating in a waveguide. We do not want any reflections to occur. So whenever we are designing all these bends, corners, etc., make sure that the equation of the mean length L is satisfied, that is, it is going to be a odd multiple of the quarter wavelength, so that reflections do not occur. Okay, and also according to Southworth, there is an equation given for the radius of curvature for a E bend and H bend, that is, R is equal to 1.5 B for an E bend and R is equal to 1.5 A for H bend, where A and B, as shown in the figure, you can refer, they are the dimensions of the waveguide. Okay, they are the dimensions of the bent. So in this section, we have seen about a hybrid ring, the nature of the hybrid ring or a rat race ring, the derivation of the S matrix for a hybrid ring, and we have seen some other type of flexible waveguides which are used for making the wave to travel in a suitable direction, that is, we can change the polarization of the wave which is traveling, or we can change the direction. So we have seen some example of the flexible waveguides: corners, bends, twists, etc. That is what we have seen in this lecture.